Viewers, like I told you on Monday, 6th January, there were always two sides to the sordid dance of violence in JNU. Today, the Delhi Police Special Investigation Cell has squarely identified 9 students for rioting on campus on Sunday, January 5th. Yes. Of the 9 students, 7 are from the left-affiliated students groups and 2 from the BJP affiliate, the ABVP. Intrinsically, we have always maintained that in this, there was no single villain. There was no one side guiltier than the other. In fact, the police has also confirmed that JNUSU president Oishe Ghosh, who has played victim, was one of the instigators and led a mob of stick-wielding, stone-pelting rioters to target a hostel that is known to be inhabited predominantly by AVP students on campus. The even-handed approach of the police has meant that those who took sides, especially the Luttian types, crying murder of democracy and the birth of Nazism, have egg on their faces. The larger question is, what makes them lie so often, so frequently? First, in the Judge Loya matter, then on Rafale, and of course, in the case of former Chief Justice of India, Deepak Mishra, who they tried to impeach. In all 3 cases, the courts came down hard and defeated, in the court's words, propaganda. Now, viewers, let's go across to Padmaja Joshi, who will now take us through the evidence the police has relied upon to identify all the mobsters. Remember, Times Now was the first to identify assailants on both sides. Padmaja.
That's right, Rahul. And in fact, these are the videos that first played on Times Now through which these 9 people have been identified. So it's not just the pictures that you will see here, but also how they were found to be involved in the JNU violence. This is Chun Chun Kumar, the accused number one, an ISA activist, incidentally an ex-student of JNU who curiously still lives on the JNU campus. This is his video from the 5th of January in the afternoon, purportedly from outside the Periyar hostel. Here you see a stick in his hand, and now you will see him pelting stones. He is seen in the company of these masked men. Let's go on to accused number 2. Accused number 2, incidentally, is Aishi Ghosh herself. Here she is seen in the police picture released of her, and here is the video based on which they have found her to be an accused. This again is outside Periyar hostel. She is seen in the company of some men who've got their faces masked. Aishi, in her defense, has said that I can only be seen in the company of masked men. That does not prove guilt or violence of any kind. I have not been seen indulging in any violence. But anyhow, here is the video. You can decide for yourself. This again is from the afternoon of Sunday. Let's take a look at accused number 3, Dolan Samantha. Now, this lady, in fact, this picture is from the 3rd of January. Why this is important is because the police says this is where the entire problem started. The left students had blockaded the server room of JNU, which meant that people, students, could not register for the upcoming winter session, the winter, the session upcoming of JNU. This is Dolan with her face covered with a red muffler, who was seen physically intercepting a boy who was going inside the server room. Again, a video that Times Now got to you first. But on the 5th night, when that video of violence came out, most people were wondering who was behind the violence of the evening of 5th of January. We showed you this picture of Vikas Patel, confirmed as a member of the ABVP right here on Times Now by the Joint Secretary Delhi of the ABVP. And today he finds himself named as accused number 9 in the pictures released by the Delhi police.
Very interesting. Now, remember, Times Now was the first channel to unmask the goons who unleashed violence in JNU on both sides. Watch how on our channel we unmasked both ABVP and left goons who terrorized students. Here is a small recap of a broadcast.
We have got images of an ABVP man holding a stick. All right? And everyone has seen that picture of Vikas Patel with a stick in his hand. Now, there is also Chun Chun, who is an ISA activist, with a stick in his hand, Sunny Dhiman, and pelting stone. So now tell me, Sunny Dhiman, that this man deserves to have an FIR against him because he has a stick in his hand. यहाँ पर आप कह रहे हैं कि दो एबीवीपी के लोग डंडा लेकर के क्यों खड़े हुए हैं अनिमा सोनकर.
Yes. So the thing is, in all the WhatsApp groups, it was so much panic was spread, so much threatened calls were given that whenever you are stepping out, step out in groups, step out while you have rods, bags, whatever you get handy.
No. So you're saying that these two members are of the ABVP? आप मान रही हैं कि दोनों ABVP के हैं?
Yes, I'm not disowning.
और ये लाठी क्यों पकड़े हुए हैं? Self-defense में लाठी पकड़े हुए हैं?
Self-defense. It's complete self-defense.
Well, these videos were of a few days ago. Meanwhile, those named as rioters say they are being unfairly targeted. Eshe Ghosh coming out with a statement of her own. Delhi police have identified 9 rioters of JNU. 7 of 9 rioters named are left affiliated. 2 students from ABVP also identified. Police say Eshe Ghosh led the mob. The proof is on CCTV videos and WhatsApp, but she says she is being framed. Watch this.
कोई भी वीडियो रिलीज हुआ है जहाँ पे मैं रॉड लेते हुए और मास्क पहनते हुए घूम रही हूँ? नहीं. सस्पेक्ट बोल देने से वो सस्पेक्ट नहीं हो जाता है, उनके पास प्रूफ भी रहना चाहिए ये बताने के लिए कि वो सस्पेक्ट हैं. हम जानना चाहते हैं कि व्हाई इज देयर इज अ सिलेक्टिव एफआईआर सडनली, व्हाई आर दे सस्पेक्टिंग मी, फ्रॉम वेयर, व्हाट इज द प्रूफ, विदाउट एनीथिंग, जस्ट टू क्रिएट अ नैरेटिव इन द मीडिया that these are the people, on what basis are you creating the narrative? Tomorrow putting our faces doesn't mean that we have done anything.
Now viewers, remember, just 2 days after the spine-chilling violence against students, actor Deepika Padukone stood shoulder to shoulder with a heavily bandaged Eshe Ghosh, and her silence signified her support. She has been hailed by Latians Delhi as an individual who has boldly endorsed one side over the other. Now, we wonder if Deepika feels she should have accepted Ajay Devgan's advice, which cautioned against taking sides before the facts were out. What about the other politicians who waded in and created the impression that one side was guilty, the other side was not? Will they take responsibility? Because as far as I can remember, this entire diatribe has been used to suggest that the Modi government is almost Nazi in its approach to dissent, and that it has a problem with a certain section of our population. Terms like McCarthyism were used. Terms which have now proven to be premature. So I want to ask some basic questions. Will the political parties and celebrities who selectively sympathize with only the left student groups now introspect about their position? Will they revise their positions? Will they say, okay, we got it a bit wrong. Maybe our own blinkered views are biased against a particular individual, government, party, etc., led us to mislead the youth of this country and, most importantly, viewers, you? That's the fundamental question. Let's open this up and let me ask the first question of Firoz Mithi Borwala, who's an activist, who perhaps has also participated in certain protests against the JNU violence, protests that were directed against the center, protests in which all sorts of extraneous slogans and issues were raised. Firoz Mithi Borwala, police has acted even-handedly. It has even named ABVP. But it has also unmasked this massive Latians leftist controversy, conspiracy, complicity in mob rioting. Firoz, can you hear me? Mithi Borwala, are you there? Can you hear me, sir?
Yeah, I can hear you. Yes.
The question is...
I'm here.
The question is, are you ready to introspect,
yeah,
sir? You're selective sympathizing with a particular narrative exposed. How will you react?
I think we are very clear. The entire episode was engineered by the, the police surrounded JNU. They let the goons in. After the violence, they let the goons out. The entire thing, Amit Shah is clearly behind this entire targeting of JNU. The facts are very much there.
Did Amit Shah give Chun Chun Kumar a stick and stones to throw?
Majorly involved in the attack. The
Did he give Aishe Ghosh the freedom to lead the mobs on Periyar Hostel?
Amit Shah is facilitated the entire process.
No, one second, sir, please. Since you think that he is such a great orchestrator,
given the instructions,
then you may as well tell me, did he ask Dolan Samantha of the ISA on 3rd January to blockade the server room and the students, poor students who come to JNU to seek out a future, from not registering for a winter semester to continue with their education? Did he arm Chun Chun Kumar, who's an ex-JNU student but lives on campus? Did he ask them to go and throw stones on ABVP? Did he do that, sir? There's the proof. See it.
I think the violence has started from the ABVP sections. The police were complicit. There were photographs and videos of ABVP mobs. The Hindu Raksha Sena is claimed responsible for the attack. The police surrounded the campus, let the goons in. After 3 hours, they let the goons out. The vice chancellor was missing from the campus. The facts are out there. The entire attack on the JNU
Sir,
was manufactured.
Sir, are you still saying that there is only one side, a side that is driven, led?
Then the police can keep fabricating.
We know driven that, and we led know by Amit Shah. Is that your charge?
We are protesting in Bombay. There is no violence in Bombay.
Okay.
Amit Shah and Yogi are responsible for the violence in
Okay.
Delhi.
Amit Shah, Yogi.
We are protesting every day in the city. And
okay. Amit Shah and Yogi responsible for Judge Loya. Amit Shah,
yes,
and Yogi
Amit
responsible
Yogi
for Rafale. Amit Shah
India.
And Yogi, sir,
massive,
look at the
protests.
Look at the litany of cases that fall flat.
Amit
you
Shah
have egg on your faces. Accept
murder,
it.
Yes.
Move on.
Yes, yes.
Let
Judge
me bring
Loya
in the BJP. Okay, let me bring
Judge
in the BJP.
Loya,
Amit
no,
Malviya,
no,
the charge is simple. You've heard the charges. You orchestrate. You then protect. You shield. You identify one group. You arm them. You then turn them against your own group. And then you say, look, the other side is to blame also. It's all fixed, says Mithi Borwala.
Yes.
You know, Rahul, the bizarreness of what I just heard is stunning. The fact really is that even before the Delhi police came out with these incriminating evidences, there were several videos and overwhelming evidences, including professors of JNU who spoke on record saying that they were manhandled, they were terrorized by the left-leaning unions because they were helping students to register. And this is not the first time something like this has happened on campus. It's happened in the past where a lady professor was confined to a room for 50 hours even without a toilet facility. That's how draconian these left union students have been. You have Abhinav Prakash on your program, I see. And today there was a poster put out in JNU calling him a traitor and asking people not to forget that he's somebody who was an insider and who let the JNU students down. And they obviously meant the left-leaning associations. So these are men who are sore of the society. These are students who are being groomed by these political parties who have lost their relevance. These are students who will further on become the more divisive elements in the society. And it is important to call them out. And I think the Delhi police, by putting out these evidences, photographs, and other evidences, has actually called off the conspiracy of several political parties, including the Congress and the left. Remember, all their leaders rushed to the campus.
Okay.
You had folks like Yogendra Yadav who were on the campus.
So you're saying, are you saying,
violence?
Sir?
How is it that Priyanka Vadra lands up at
No, that's
Ames?
Fine. But are you also saying that the JNU VC must escape blame for delay in reacting to the complaint made to him when the mobs were terrorizing JNU? You can't extend the logic, can you?
Exactly.
Well, on the 3rd, when the server room was vandalized, I understand that the VC informed the administration, but there is a process within the university of setting up a proctorial committee before a formal FIR is launched, which was done on the 6th of January. On the 4th and 5th was followed with unprecedented violence, and the left union students are completely to be blamed for it. There are several video evidences, including the one where they went into cold.
There are also two ABVP men.
And two
ABVP men have also been named,
sir. Last 1 week.
I have always maintained,
yes,
here, viewers,
there were two ABVP,
and we stand totally vindicated. There were two sides, but unfortunately, there is no excuse for this, though. While there have been two sides, one side has decided to selectively pick and push a narrative, and it has led, viewers, to furious editorials in newspapers. It has led to various people petitioning the government, saying that you have wrecked democracy in this country. What about those people? And I want to ask them, Suman C. Raman, I want to ask you, Mr. Muntashit, I want to ask you, sir.
Yeah.
Rizwan K. sir. I want to ask all
can
of you.
Can I speak, Rahul?
I want Rahul. To ask you.
Shall I intervene?
Yeah, Rahul.
Will you take responsibility, sir?
The fundamental difference.
No, will you take responsibility tonight?
Rahul,
if you want me to ask you, then hear the question. Will you take responsibility tonight for going out there, misleading individuals, driving them into a frenzy so they even stand in protest and hold up Free Kashmir posters? Will you today? Tell me.
Rahul, even.
You think we are fools?
Even as you speak. Another channel is actually putting out a sting operation.
I don't care, sir. Sting operations are paid. They are paid propaganda, sir. 95% of the times,
okay,
you have sat here and accused us of doing the same. So be today. No, one second. You stop cherry picking. You can't come on another day on one channel and say, oh, those things that Times Now does are paid propaganda. What some other god awful a bunch of people do. I don't know. I don't take responsibility. And that is the truth. Don't do this. Stop doing this.
According to
you are a learned man. You are an intellectual. You need to understand, sir, that you cannot jump to conclusions. You cannot jump to conclusions on the back of flimsy evidence. And I will not sit here and listen to your nonsense. You need to explain. Did you jump to a conclusion? Did you drive people into a state of frenzy? Did you create an atmosphere of suspicion?
Another channel is saying,
I don't care about any other channel, sir. We are talking about Times Now. We have exposed something. We stand vindicated. I'm not picking a side. I don't care if other channels want to pick sides. You can go, sir, and represent yourself on that channel. Be my guest. But I'm asking you a simple question. I have in my studio tonight a professor of DU. He is an assistant professor in SRCC. There are today posters
up
calling for an attack on this man, and I will show you those posters. Are you going to take responsibility tomorrow if Abhinav Prakash is beaten up? I want to ask you. General G.D. Bakshi is also there. Let's put out, there's the poster. I want us to go full frame on this poster. This is irresponsible, viewers. There are people with families whose names are today being rubbished, maligned. Is this acceptable? Abhinav Prakash, he is being accused of being an RSS troll. Made
says that the
a reckonance
police were called
in JNU and created the violence. Why don't
figures.
You speak, sir? Abhinav Prakash,
exactly.
You speak. You tell this man who sits here and takes positions on the basis of flimsy facts why today you feel.
Well, basically, I was taking class today and I just got a message that is a poster out in the campus accusing me of violence. And it was quite painful because I have not been to JNU campus for more than a month. And I'm not involved in the JNU politics or anything for more than 3-4 years. And absolutely from nothing.
Are you an architect of violence? Are you a traitor?
I don't know. I mean, I have been criticizing the left for.
Are you, sir? I'm asking you. Are you an architect of violence?
Of course not, sir.
Of course not. Where were you, sir,
no
on the given days?
On the Sunday.
Where were you on the given days?
I was at my home. It was Sunday. I was sleeping. At 7 o'clock, I opened my Twitter. I see something has happened to JNU. All I did was to collect information and started tweeting them. The one thing I was tweeting continuously that the violence is not one-sided. There was a violence in the afternoon led by the left parties, and I think that is why I have been targeted. But I have been criticizing the left.
Now, General Bakshi, I want to bring you in, General Bakshi, tonight.
Never before General Bakshi, by any left.
I want to ask you a straightforward question. You have been warned against using the phrase tukre gang. Why? Because they say people like you create hate psychosis against the so-called tukre gang. Now today you have Abhinav Prakash sitting here, and they are calling him an architect of violence and a traitor of JNU. Isn't this shameful? This false equivocation? General Bakshi, I want to ask you this question.
Rahul.
Yes. Tell me.
On what basis Rahul Bakshi know
yes.
that?
Rahul, I would like to tell you that the JNU has been the epicenter of a consistent separatist leftist narrative. They are extremely economical with the truth. To the contrary, they are experts, spin masters, and spin masters of an order which, having served in the information warfare department myself, I can tell you, it has a degree of professional, touch to it, a consistent anti-national narrative, a tukde gang be damned, a narrative to break up the country,
you, 30 seconds.
A narrative to support terrorists
you,
of the order of Afzal Guru. Can I please finish? Because these people, they will not let anybody else speak.
No, when you're telling lies, I cannot let you finish without the challenge.
I'm here to debate as
Mr. Sunit Tandon.
All right.
Let him speak. Let him speak, Mr. Tandon. Let him speak.
Institution.
Sunit Chopra. Let him speak, Mr. Sunit Chopra.
By a set of people who have tremendous amount of backing in the media, they are carrying out influence operations. Information operations of a level of sophistication which is now becoming cause for serious concern.
Okay.
Rahul, it is becoming cause for serious concern.
Okay.
The level of sophistication, the level of denial. You are seeing it on
sophistication,
your own
denial, conspiracy. Let me bring in Rizwan Kesar, head of Department of History at the Jamia Millia Islamia. Okay, let me ask him. Let me ask him. Sir, answer my question. Answer my question straight.
Okay.
Two questions. Will the witch hunt against ABVP students and teachers on JNU campus now end when it emerges they were victims also? And can the Delhi police be accused of partisanship when they have booked ABVP mobsters also?
Two very quick things, Rahul.
Please respond.
Two very, very quick things. Delhi police, which has been known for being very professional, did very unprofessional thing in Jamia.
So please answer the questions.
I'm answering, Rahul. You cannot ask me to answer on a particular line, brother.
Jamia.
I've asked you two questions. You're going into a third issue.
You gave me uninterrupted 2 minutes, Rahul. Otherwise, I have no business being here. Give me two uninterrupted minutes. Delhi police, which has been known as a professional police, did very unprofessional things in Jamia campus. It is that image which has carried over in JNU, number one. Number two, General Bakshi repeatedly calling JNU being anti-nationalist, separatist. I don't know. I don't think he is careful with the choice of his words.
Sir, can I ask you a question? Unprofessional in what sense?
I'm answering your
unprofessional
question,
in what sense? They came in to resort.
It's
One second. They came in to prevent people who were throwing stones and who ran inside.
It was
1 second. Jamia, after burning people's cars, setting public buses on fire.
The police should have dealt with them there.
People run left, right, and center, and you're expecting how many police officers you think we should have?
In one place.
No, you're not going to blame the mobsters. You're going to blame the police who restore order. Come on, sir. Let's have a sense of perspective. But nonetheless, I know you're trying to.
You are now trying to serve.
Look, I've asked a question of the Delhi police. I said, why did they not react? They said the VC didn't call us. Let's stick to JNU. Why are you muddying the waters further? You know there are two sides of the story even in Jamia. Now you need to answer. You need to answer, sir. Can the Delhi police be accused of partisanship when they have booked ABVP monster?
Which is the best university in the country.
ABVP mobsters have also been charged. Can you still say, there's a police? Now you're going on to something else. I've asked you, sir, why don't you answer my question?
Please, Rahul, please.
Is it so tough?
Ask me and give me time to answer.
I have asked you, sir, but you don't answer.
I'm here to answer your question.
So please.
You haven't given him time. Don't hide behind
Mr.
words.
Referee, calm down.
Now the question is that let there be impartial investigation. People have demanded, you know, judicial inquiry by sitting or retired Supreme Court judge into Jamia episode and JNU episode. Let the truth come out.
Sir.
But then before that has happened,
I'm asking you a simple question. Rahul, I beg you, answer my question, sir.
Please.
No
whataboutry.
Please, I'm asking you a question. Will you still today say that the police has acted in a partisan way when they have gone ahead and booked alleged mobsters also of the ABVP? Now tell me.
No, very small question.
You have an answer, or you don't have
Rahul,
the answer?
No, I have.
Then tell me, sir, what
you know,
the answer.
Aishi Ghosh has got 16 stitches on her head. Now, what is the evidence that she was leading a rioters mob?
Sir, I'm asking you a question. The videos are there, sir. When you point a whole bunch of people with sticks and stones in the direction of a hostel, what is that called?
What?
It's abetment to rioting, isn't it, sir?
Can I have 1 minute, please?
Yes, sir. Please. See, since you want to answer the question, yes.
Since what is happening in the JNU is that after the Kanhaiya Kumar episode, there is a competitive radicalism going on between the left parties who want to follow the same path to the national success. And this is why you see suddenly since 2016 in JNU, you have one outrageous thing happening after another. This was not the case.
Sir, do you support the criminalization of a professor who was not even there? Do you support that?
Do you support
I'm asking you.
Do you support,
do you support the criminalization?
Suchitra Sen?
I want to come to Kundan Deval.
Sen?
Kundan Deval, let me come out to you.
Bhadri.
Kundan
Sangata
Deval, I want to ask you a simple question. Manoj Muntashi. Please. He's not going to. He's not going to answer that question.
You are not even denouncing
me. I'm not even denouncing a teacher myself.
Thank you, sir. Thank you for being honest tonight.
I'm against any attack on teachers.
Please denounce
it.
For the record,
two teachers in jail.
I want to bring in Kundan Deval. Kundan Deval, 1 second.
What do you say about them?
I have not seen you denouncing anyone else on the campus.
That brutal attack on them?
I have denounced all the violence repeatedly on the social media. Have you denounced the slander campaign against me?
Sucharita Sen and Saugata Bhadri?
Okay, I want to ask a basic question tonight.
You are part of the slander
Kundan Deval.
You are also part of the slander campaign.
Okay, let me go across to Kundan Deval. This poor man, sir, his face is plastered all over universities on a false charge. And you are saying that he is part of a slander campaign. He's a victim.
Gentlemen, please, Kundan Deval, I can denounce you right away. Yes, Rahul, I want to ask you a basic question, ma'am, and it's a straightforward question.
After today, do you think students like Aishi Ghosh, students from the ABVP who have been named, students from other leftist organizations who have been named, Dolan Samantha, you've had, of course, from the ABVP, the others who we have just talked about, I want to ask you, should they be now suspended pending inquiry and also pending police action? Should they be suspended?
Come in.
Okay, Rahul, do you complete it with your question?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. So I have a request like I have a request. Please give me 2 minutes like uninterrupted 2 minutes. Like I want to complete my thing and it's a request to everyone. Please listen the point of view of the JNU and then decide what you are deciding. Okay, because the current regime is only giving the point of view of one side, that's the problem, and the police is part of that and the JNU administration is also a part of that. So today there is a press conference from the police, so Delhi police, but the problem is that they haven't mentioned the name of Sabarmati. They haven't mentioned the violence that happened in the Sabarmati, and that was the main issue there, because there were the outsider people and outsider insider, like both the people, and they have, you know, they mask their faces and they have rods, they have, you know, hampers, and they have,
ma'am, you know, you might be a very honest person. You might be a very honest person, ma'am.
So that's the problem.
Okay,
that's,
I've given you 2 minutes. You haven't answered my question.
Let her finish.
People on both sides. People on both sides have been charged.
There should be inquiry. Yeah, your question is that there is, yeah, both side of people. But they, the police haven't mentioned the name of the Sabarmati incident, and that the accusers.
Ma'am, has the inquiry ended? No. The inquiry is beginning. You have been constantly asking for information. So the police have said, this is what we know for now.
So
here it is.
So why?
Here are what our conclusions are.
So
the inquiry has not been wrapped up, madam. The inquiry has not been wrapped up. You are taking this as final. Now, 1 minute. I want to bring in Amit Malviya. Amit Malviya?
Yes, yes. But that's why I'm saying.
Amit Malviya?
That's why I'm saying
police. Police has not been thorough enough, is what Ms. Kundan Deval is saying.
Fair inquiry.
How much fairer? People on both sides have been named. ABVP and left. Now, there are video evidences, and they have been produced, and they have been shown to you. Nonetheless, let me take it to Mr. Malviya. Mr. Malviya is the police force in Delhi under pressure from the Union Home Minister. Simple question to you.
Naturally. You know, Rahul, these people will not be satisfied with anything as long as it is not their way. Even if the Supreme Court opined on it, they will have a problem with it. We've seen in the past, they insist on it being their way or highway. They respect no institution. There have been several judgments where they have abused every institution, from the Election Commission to the Supreme Court.
Well,
so you can't expect anything better from them. I think the Delhi police were very categorical in saying that they're putting out the information that they have so far. They will come back again for further updates. So they should wait for the further updates. But the fact today is that several students of the ABVP have beaten up mercilessly.
I need to step in here. Viewers, you've heard both sides.
They are at the moment
both sides,
recovering.
Then why put both sides why created a narrative. This both sides created a narrative. The police have blamed both sides, viewers. You've heard that one was a greater villain than the other. Well, the police doesn't think so. In the police's books, viewers, and I'm underlining this word, both sides are at fault. I always told you, this channel always told you, there were always two sides. There was propaganda, however, that was unleashed on a gigantuan scale. Gigantuan. From here to New York, there have been protests in every foreign capital. Are those protesters going to introspect tonight? Will they come out and say we maligned our country first? Forget about the facts. Maligned the country. Think about that. I'll take a short break. We return. Viewers, what is happening today in the ecosystem propagated by the left is absolutely unjustifiable. There is targeted harassment now. People are being treated like wanted terrorists. Their photographs have appeared on walls. They are being called the traitors of JNU, architects of violence. One of those individuals, viewers, is sitting in our studio and he is shocked. He is a member of the SRCC faculty. He's an assistant professor. He wasn't even there at JNU when the violence was unspiraling to disastrous consequences. These people today are fearing for their lives. On the one side, you hear constantly politicians coming out and saying, don't call Kanhaiya Kumar and company Tukre Tukre Gang. Why? Because you're creating hatred against them. Fair enough. Okay. You believe so. You have a right to say it. But then you put the names of people who you have no proof against on the walls of JNU. This story is a shocker, viewers. It's not defendable. You're putting innocents without proof in harm's way. If they're lynched tomorrow, what happens? Padmaja Joshi has more details on this. Padmaja, what can you tell us? Okay, we're going to try and get her in 30 seconds on this story. It's an important story, viewers. Have a look at these pictures. Abhinav Prakash is here with us. Abhinav, I want you to tell our viewers what's going through your mind as we open this out.
Well, I'm really shocked because I do not have any association with the JNU politics or its internal workings for more than 5 years now. And I haven't been to JNU campus for almost more than a month now. Absolutely no idea from where my name is being circulated. I think that is because I have been a very vocal critical of the left politics of the JNU. Since 2011 and 12, in the best traditions of JNU, I've been writing against that how the left, the old left in JNU is collapsing and is being replaced by the anarchy, and how the JNU campus is becoming a...
You're a victim.
Yeah, I'm a victim of that anarchy.
You're a victim, aren't you? Let's open this up. A victim sitting right here. I wonder if Deepika Padukone or anyone from celebrity circles will tweet today a condemnation against those. And can we open this out, Nizam Bhai, please, 30 seconds? I want to go across to our guests because it's very important. It's an important story. And I want to begin to ask Suman C. Raman. Suman C. Raman, here are pictures of Deepika Padukone from 2 or 3 days ago, standing next to Aishi Ghosh. Giving her unstinting support. Bollywood came up and said, what a great act. You're standing with victims.
Why not?
Standing with victims. Will she stand with the victim of this slander? Of this anarchist campaign? Sitting in our studios?
Look.
Abhinav Prakash.
There is no anarchist campaign.
Whoever put
this
out these man posters, one
put
minute.
Out tweets. He said
one
so.
Minute, there is no.
Did you put out
Deepika
tweets?
Padukone. One minute.
Did you put out tweets?
Deepika Padukone.
I have been tweeting
adult.
That the violence
she
has not been one sided. I have been tweeting that there was an afternoon violence in which JNUC president was seen in the picture. I think that is the reason I have been targeted.
So, yes.
That's the only reason I have been targeted. I'm pretty sure about it.
So he called out the truth, the truth which has been vindicated by a police inquiry. And you want to, sir, call him a traitor?
That's not the truth.
No, you want to call him a
he
traitor? And you have a problem when
not
people call Kanhaiya Kumar a traitor?
One minute.
Come on.
Yes.
Sunit Chopra.
Not only a traitor.
How dare you sit here, sir,
look,
today and rationalize? One absolute.
So.
No, 1 minute. How do you rationalize this?
Sir, if you
call
how do you rationalize
so.
This?
I'm anyways trying to take a legal
so.
Action, and your name will be the top of it.
So. You quizzlings, I don't care about you.
Quizzlings?
I don't know what he's talking about. He's a madman.
That's the
Rahul.
Truth.
Quizzlings?
Yes. You've sold out.
I mean.
Sold out?
What's going
yes.
on?
Sold out?
Rahul, can we get beyond this name calling?
Yes.
You know, General Bakshi, General Bakshi, these people,
Rahul, exactly.
all they're left with today are ugly abuses. No one votes for them in their traditional strongholds. And sir, do you justify this?
Yeah.
This speech that we're hearing, this tirade from Sunit Chopra?
Kerala government is the
whatever,
best
Sunit Chopra, do you justify this?
No, absolutely. Look,
Rahul,
let me tell you, being part of the teaching
is he also sold out?
Rahul. Being, listen to me.
Oh,
listen
Rahul.
To me carefully.
Rahul.
Being part
Rahul.
Of the teaching fraternity, out-condemn any act of threat, any fellow faculty member, Rahul. But at the same time, you should have had the opportunity of calling Sucharita Sen, who was
Rahul, there is so much
I want to ask you.
You should have
I want to ask you, sir.
Bhadri,
I want to ask you today. I want to ask you, professor. I want to ask you, doctor. I want to ask you,
Sucharita.
Suman C. Raman, Dr. Suman C. Raman. Are you going to today take responsibility if something happens to the gentleman who's standing in my studio? Will you take responsibility?
I condemn. I condemn unequivocally
Rahul,
the people who have put out the poster.
Thank
but
you, sir.
That does not justify.
It's not good enough, sir. You should be
day.
Calling for an inquiry against those people
Professor
who have
Sucharita
put out this poster. Who do they think they are? The Indian state?
Please.
Who do they think they are?
Order the inquiry.
The government of India? The police? The NIA?
Order
who
an
are these
inquiry.
People? They need to be identified. Go ahead. If you have the guts, sir, call this out for what it is.
Bloody
call it out. This is McCarthyism. This is McCarthyism, sir. When you don't agree with somebody, what do? You put their names on walls and you call them traitors? How dare you? Shameful. General Bakshi wants to come in. General Bakshi.
Deepika Padukone is supporting anti-national.
Who has been saying anti-national?
Deepika Padukone is supporting
Rahul,
anti-national. Why are you going after her?
Rahul. Rahul, can I kindly have my seconds. Say? Rahul, can I
so
kindly
don't
have
go ahead, sir. General Bakshi,
okay.
We won't go ahead.
Rahul, since Rahul, I'm not getting to speak,
Rahul,
I do not think that there is any point of me being in this panel. I should be going out. I have better things to do.
JNU has become the epicenter of an orchestrated campaign to demonize the Indian state and its security agencies. The police is damned if it does.
Respond to that.
If it goes after arsonists.
Manoj Muntashir, respond to that.
Shelter in Jamia Millia.
Respond
it
to
is blamed.
I just want to say one thing, Rahul.
It does not
Rahul,
go into JNU. It is blamed. It is an orchestrated complete information warfare offensive. And you can see
what
the
is happening
scope
that
the
is
scale.
Totally absurd to blame Mr. Modi and Mr. Shah for whatever has happened in JNU. It is absurd. Totally absurd. It is like irresponsible as well. But at the same time, I do not understand the need of the hour. Why was Delhi police so much in rush to come with the half-cooked and half-baked investigation?
Because you pressured them.
Clearly
you said that you were hiding facts. You came out and started writing editorials. You started picketing the police headquarters. You inconvenienced half of India.
Definitely there was a
sir, because with your slander campaign.
But then this half-narrative misleads
1 minute.
People.
I want to go across to Padmaja Joshi. Let's cut through all this. I want to ask her to define and tell us why this is McCarthyism in a modern age.
You know, it's insane. First of all, it is for the police to identify people and then take action against them. Who are these vigilantes at large who have decided to put up posters? And this is not just one instance. Our team has actually gone, Rahul, and found that on walls, on benches across JNU, you've got these posters where you have got A, professors who have been identified, named, and said things like traitors of JNU, architects of violence. So first of all, who are they supposed to bear allegiance to if they are supposed to be traitors now because of whatever disservice they are alleged to have done? And it's not just professors alone. There's another poster here, which I would like to zoom into, which actually identifies students. And students, their pictures, including one woman, have been put up. And it says here, these goons have been found directly involved in the attack that happened to our JNU. We regret and are ashamed that these people were part of our hostel. We declare them out of bounds from the premises of the hostel. Who are these extra constitutional authorities who decide who gets to be in a hostel, who gets to be loyal, and who is declared a traitor, Rahul?
I can't understand, because I want to ask you this. Chun Chun is a character who has passed out and he's living in the hostel. On what grounds is he living in a hostel when he's passed out of JNU? Padmaja Joshi?
Exactly. And you know, that is a question raised again and again. So at least three people, when we were speaking to students in JNU, they said that, you know, when everyone kept talking about outsiders, they weren't really outsiders. There are people who are staying in the JNU hostel. But when everyone kept speaking about outsiders, it is because there were some people who weren't really students of JNU anymore, but continued to stay on campus, and which is why their role also needs to be specially investigated as to in which capacity they remain on the university premises and continue to stay there. They have the right to continue, by the way. But these students have been declared out of bounds. They have been thrown out, identified, and the hostel has been declared out of bounds for them. If this is not a witch hunt, social boycott, bullying. I have spoken to a girl today, Rahul, who said, I am living in Indore for the last 5 days because when I went back to the hostel, I was told you're from the ABVP. Now you watch your back. And so she's been called away by her parents.
My God. My God. Invitation to lynching. This is what is passing off as peaceful protest in JNU. This is the face. Firoz Mithi Borwala, do you condemn this? Do you condemn this, sir? Do you want students to now put up names of each other and say, let's come out and show them what it's all about? Mithi Borwala.
No, I don't want them to do that. But the original... I don't want them to do that. I condemn it entirely. But the original call to lynch people on a scale was when Modi said, kapro se pehchane jayenge. That was the call, free call for lynching people, which they've been doing for the last 5.5 years. Firstly, Modi should take back his statement and apologize to the nation for calling out the entire Muslim community when he said
Tibowala, you can twist everyone's words whichever way you want to. We have the BJP here. They're going to respond on that particular statement. Once again, what about tree? Once again, what about tree? You think about those poor students who can't enter their university because they are threatened on their face.
This is what Hitler did.
No, no, with harm. You're okay with that? You're okay with that? Okay, let me bring it. Amit Malviya. Amit Malviya, respond to Mitti Borwala. Respond to it.
Fighting the fascist mobs.
Fascist mob, everyone is a fascist for you. When they don't suit, when they don't suit your point of view, sir. It's fine. Amit Malviya.
Not us.
Amit Malviya. Face off. Amit Malviya.
How is Rahul? At least Borwala has accepted that it were the Muslims who were rioting on the streets of India. And therefore he must also explain why were they raising seditious slogans. Now that he's decided to call them out, he should also come out and say, why did the Muslims destroy properties, buses, railways? Why does he not come out and speak about that? The kind of mayhem and violence that we saw. So it's all convenient to call them out, and I'm glad Borwala has done it. But the fact is that as far as lynching is concerned, the father of lynching is Rajiv Gandhi, the party that he supports. 1984 Sikh genocide is not lost on anybody. So let him not
the father of
further his
Godse,
political
Godse.
Agenda
the
in the name of students or otherwise.
Today? Will you condemn Godse
don't
today?
Talk rubbish.
Okay.
Don't talk
well,
rubbish.
Viewers,
will you condemn Godse today
viewers,
on national TV?
Viewers, just look at this. Look at this. This is the equivalence that is falsely drawn every night on national TV. Here is something that we all must condemn with all our might. Because McCarthyism, a term borrowed from 1950s United States, perhaps even a little earlier, was thought to be a crime against humanity. Today, it is valorized, it is backed by goons from the left who have appointed themselves the moral guardians of our society. Think about this, viewers, the next time. And this is what is passing off as protest in JNU. They say, you must never boycott Chapak. Of course, they're right. And they boycott students. They launch tirades against them. They ban them from their campuses. And they leave professors fearing for their lives. Think about this. Yes, the last few words.
When you're talking about fascism, the fascism is when you say JNU lal hai or JNU left ka hai. Because JNU is not red. There is ABVP, there are Dalit parties, there are Ambedkarite parties, OBC parties. You cannot say
you
that
can't
JNU,
say R, JNU
lal
and
hai
there JNU,
JNU
there is no R and there JNU belongs to.
And I'm being called traitor on what basis?
Well,
on what basis
well,
I'm being called a traitor to JNU? I never
I suggest you should approach the police immediately and seek cover. I need to move on, viewers. I need to move on. There have been other developments today. After the police press conference establishes that there are two protagonists in the dance of violence, Union Minister Smriti Irani's remarks are proving to be prophetic. With tongue firmly in cheek, Irani took a dig at Deepika Padukone for endorsing the Tukre Tukre gang and those who have made a career out of abusing the forces. Listen to what Smriti Irani said. Listen to this.
I think I would rather know what a political affiliation is than not know. I think that anybody who has read the news knew where you're going to stand. Knew that you're going to stand with people who wanted the destruction of India. Knew that you're standing with people who celebrate every time a CRPF jawan is killed. She knew that she's standing with people who they actually hit some girls in private parts of Lathis. So she stood next to them. That is her right. I can't deny her that right. As far as Deepika goes, I rather know where she stands.
My only question.
She stood in level. It's her right. Stand next to people.
There you heard it, viewers. I want to come out to you, Abhinav Prakash. And if Mr. Amit Malviya can hear me, I don't think he's connected. I think he's not there for the... General Bakshi, today Smriti Irani has taken a position against Deepika Padukone. Do you think she's said the right things?
You know, the simple fact is that you must reflect before you act. Just for the sake of, I'm very sorry to state, she's a very respected actress in the Bombay fraternity. But just for the sake of promoting a film, you don't wade, you know, you don't rush in. Angels don't rush in, you know, because where fools rush in, where angels fear to tread. Without establishing facts, you are now watching that the whole thing was orchestrated by and large by the leftist goons, by people who are middle-aged residents of a hostel where you pay 10 rupees a month and you continue to stay there for the rest of your lives. Trying to arrest, please.
Ajay Devgan, today,
and a member of the same film fraternity. Please allow me one thing.
Yeah,
Rahul.
Please, sir. Go ahead. Rahul. General, go ahead.
Rahul, please.
Go ahead.
Rahul,
go ahead.
Rahul, can I?
Go ahead.
Rahul, there is a failed communist ideology failed the world over. Why is it being thrust down our throats? These are the people who committed the Tiananmen Square massacre against the students. These are the people who, you know, wiped out 30 million Chinese in the Gulag.
Kundan Deval, Kundan Deval, I feel sorry. My heart goes out to someone like...
Revolution.
No, no, my heart goes out also to individuals who have rushed to take a position when they know that the facts are completely different. And that shows that there was a motivated attention. I need to move on, viewers. I need to move on.
Traitors with a capital D. How long are we supposed to suffer?
Well,
silence.
Well, viewers, let's move on. Let's move on. Thank you. Thank you for joining us. But I just want to quickly... Before I end, there's a massive controversy now raging on a video that has been tweeted by the Bharatiya Janata Party. In the video, there are some slogans that are being chanted purportedly outside of Jamia Millia Islamia. Now, these slogans, I don't know their authenticity. I can't say whether this is right or wrong. The BJP has tweeted it. There's a huge controversy over it. First, listen to this video. Jinnawali Azadi is what is being chanted according to this particular tape released by the Bharatiya Janata Party, in fact, a worker of the Bharatiya Janata Party. The BJP is standing behind it, but the Congress is saying it's fake. Listen to their reactions.
I don't know what kind of what they consume or what they why they make those slogans. I think they are completely this is a huge disconnect from rest of India. I think a few hundred or a few dozen people are actually indulging in this kind of seditious propaganda. And those who want Jinnawali Azadi, I think they are welcome to apply for citizenship in Pakistan and go and enjoy it there.
By saying that we have unfortunately seen that some people associated with the ruling party have no compunctions about even issuing videos whose authenticity has been severely doubted. Do not forget that this entire business about tukde tukde, which is one of the favorite phrases of the tukde tukde gang that are ruling us today, they circulated that video in 2015 at the time of the Kanhaiya Kumar issue in JNU. And to this day, nobody has been able to demonstrate that that is actually true. It seems to have been dubbed onto the soundtrack.